BBC Television presents...
Hancock.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. I've come in answer to your advert on the wall next to the Eagle Laundry in Pelham Road.
An advert?
Yes, your poster. You must have seen it. There's a nurse pointing at you. No, I believe she's a Red Cross lady, actually, with a moustache and a beard. I've penciled in, of course. You must know it. It's one of yours, definitely one of yours, next to Hands Off Cuba, just above the cricket stuff. It says, your blood can save a life.
Oh, I see. You wish to become a blood donor.
I certainly do. I've been thinking about this for a long time. Something for the benefit of the country as a whole. What should it be, I thought? Become a blood donor or join the Young Conservatives? Anyway, as I'm not looking for a wife and I can't play table tennis, here I am. A body full of good British blood and raring to go.
Yes, quite. Well, if you'll just sit down a moment, I'll take a few particulars, if I may. May I have your name?
Hancock. Anthony Hancock, twice candidate for the county council elections, defeated. Onsec British Legion, Earl's Court Branch, treasurer of the darts team and the outings committee.
I only want the name.
We're going to Margate this year by boat. If there's any young nurses like yourself who care to join us, be more than happy to accommodate you. No nonsense and all, you know what I mean.
Thank you, I'll bear it in mind. Yes. Date of birth?
Yes, well, shall we say the 12th of May, 19... I always remember the 12th of May, yes. It was Coronation Day, you know, in 1936.
You're only 25.
No. The coronation was in 1936. I was born a little before that in 19... Is all this really necessary?
Yes, sir, I'm afraid it is. The 12th of May.
Yes. Yes, I always remember that, the coronation. We all got a day off at our school, did you? We got a cup and a saucer. Got a cup and a saucer and a box and a bar of soap. Very good, very good. I've still got that today. And a spoon for the silver jubilee and a biscuit tin with their pictures on.
How old are you?
35.
Nationality?
Ah, you've got nothing to worry about there. It's the blood you're thinking about, isn't it? British. British, undiluted for 12 generations. 100% Anglo-Saxon with perhaps just a dash of Viking. Nothing else has crept in, no? Anybody who gets any of this will have nothing to complain about. There's aristocracy in there, you know. You want to watch who you're giving it to. It's like motor oil. It doesn't mix, if you get my meaning.
Mr. Hancock, when a blood transfusion is being given, the family background is of no consequence.
Oh, come now, surely you don't expect me to believe that. I mean, after all, East is East, really.
And blood is blood all over the world, Mr. Hancock. It is classified by groups and not by accidents of birth.
I did not come here for the lecture on communism, young lady.
I happen to be a conservative.
Then kindly behave like one, madam.
Have you had any of these diseases?
No, I have not, and especially not that one. I told you before, you have nothing to fear from me. I'm perfectly healthy, fit, fit. If we only had our own rocket, I could have been the first one up there. I'd be named down for the blue streak, but no, we missed our chance again. It's not right having in these... Not right having these foreigners hurtling round up there. You mark my words.
Mr. Hancock.
Eh?
Oh. Blood.
Yes, I beg your pardon. Get carried away over things like that. It's a sore point with me. You ready now?
Well, there is just one more thing. Have you ever given any blood before?
Given? No. Spilt? Yes. Yes, there's a good few drops lying about on the battlefields of Europe. Are you familiar with the Ardennes? I remember von Rundstedt's last push. Tiger Harrison and myself, being in a forward position, were cut off behind the enemy line. Captain Harrison, I said. Yes, sir, he said. Jerry's overlooked us, I said. Where shall we head for? Berlin, he said. Right, I said. Last one in the Reichstag's a sissy. So, we set off, got there 3 days before the Russians.
You've never given any blood before?
No, so there we were, surrounded by stormtroopers. Kamerad, kamerad, they said.
Now, if you'll just sit over there with the others, Doctor will call you when he's ready.
Thank you. So we started rounding them up and oh. Well. No.
Well, it's a grand job we're all doing. Yes, I think we can all be very proud of ourselves. Some people, all they do is take out of life, never put anything back. Well, that is not my way of living and never has been. You're only entitled to take out of life what you are prepared to put into it. Do you get a badge for doing this?
No, I don't think so.
Pity. We should have something for people to pick us out by.
Surely that's not the important thing. I mean, just as long as we give the blood and help somebody, that's the main thing.
Oh, well, that's quite, as long as they get the old corpuscles. Quite. That's reward in itself, I agree. No names, no pack drill. Quite. I just think we want to get a badge as well. You know, nothing grand, a little enamel thing, a little motto, that's all, nothing pretentious, something like, he gave it for others so that others may live. I mean, we are do-gooders, we should get something for it.
What do you want, money?
Don't be vulgar. Great believer in charity, help others, that's my motto. I contribute to every flag day that's going. Now, the lapels of my suits are always the first thing to go. Covered in holes they are. Yes, I always give what I can. Here, have a look at this. Look at this. It's all down here in my diary. Congo Relief, 2 and 6. Self-denial week, 1 and 8. Lifeboat Day at Tanna. Arab refugees, 1 and 2. Yes, it's all down here, yes. Yes, I do what I can. My conscience is clear. And when I'm finally called by the great architect, and they say, what did you do? I shall just bring me book out and I shall say, here you are, mate. Count that lot up. I got nothing to fear. I could go tomorrow. Ah, yes. Do you come here often?
This is my 12th time.
There's no need to boast about it, old man. How much did you give to the Arab refugees?
Oh, really?
Come on. How much? You're shouting about how much blood you've given. How much did you give to the Arab refugees?
Well, if you must know, I gave £5.
Ah, well, there you are. I mean, some people are better placed than others, that's all.
Well, let's forget all about it, John.
That's all right, yes.
Johnson, we're ready for you now.
Oh, thank you very much.
That's a bit of a big head, isn't he? You can't give to charity without shouting about it from the rooftops. Is this your first time?
I come every 6 months, for the last 12 years.
Yes, well, you've got a bit to spare, haven't you? I mean, too much blood is as bad as too little, I always say.
Are you trying to be insulting?
No, nothing personal, just an observation. I think it's very laudable to give so much. Of course, some people make it up quicker than others. I mean, I expect you'd be a big eater, you know, you'd make you fight. Whereas with other people, it wouldn't take you as long to recoup a woman of your build for the... they certainly brighten these hospitals. Yeah, because the health service has done that, you know. They spend more money on paint. Out of every 13 and 6 paid in, 6 and 8 goes up on the wall. Still, it's worth it. I mean, after all, I mean, you can't...
Miss Forsyth, we're ready for you now.
Well, best of luck. Just think Cliff Richard might get your lot. That'd slow him down a bit, wouldn't it? Drink a pint of milk a day. Drink a pint of milk a day. Coughs and sneezes spread diseases. Coughs and sneezes spread diseases. Drop the germs in your handkerchief. Coughs and sneezes spread diseases. Sorry, a bit lonely, no? Funny the things you do on your own, isn't it? Yes. This, normal sort of day for you, then? Same amount of people as normally? Or, is it about normal?
It's about average.
Yes, yes, quite. Yes, indeed, my word, yes. Of course, it's a vocation, nurse, and I've always said that. One of the highest callings a woman can aspire to. It's not the money, is it? Strange, isn't it, the different values we place in society? I mean, you take modelling. You get some skinny bird up in the West End, all bones and salt cellars, dragging a piece of fur along a platform, 50 quid a week. And there's you lot, dedicated, 3 years training, humping great trolley loads of mints about all day long. Not right, there's Adam Faith earning 10 times as much as the Prime Minister. Is that right? Is that right? Mind you, I suppose it depends on whether you like Adam Faith and what your politics are. I understand we get tea and biscuits after.
Yes.
But no badge.
No.
No. You're taking the time in there, aren't they? I suppose everything's all right.
Yes.
Just wondered. I just thought some of the poor devils might pass out at the sight of a needle. I've seen it before. Men built like oak trees, keeling over like saplings in a hurricane.
Needles don't bother you, then?
Oh, me, no. I've had too many of them, my dear. I've had the lot. Got arms like pincushions. Yes, I reckon I've had a syringe full of everything that's going in my time. Needles the size of drain pipes, some of them. You name it, I've had it.
Mr. Hancock, doctor's ready for you now.
Who, me? What, yes. Now? Well, I'm in no hurry, you know. I think, anybody wants to go before me, I don't mind. Does anybody want to still...
There isn't anybody else. You are the last one.
Yes. Well, this is it then, over the top. What's he like on the needle, this bloke? Has he got a steady hand?
Oh, you'll be quite all right.
He's in a good mood.
You'll be perfectly all right. Dr. McTaggart's an excellent doctor.
Dr. McTaggart, he's a Scotsman. Oh, that's fine. They're all good doctors, Scotsmen, yes. Like engineers, you know. It's the porridge that does it. Right. Hi. Carry on, Macduff.